So this is my physical chemistry task, 19.67, and in the following I'm going to solve it step by step. So for a particular reaction, delta G is 30 kilojoule and delta S is 90 joule per Kelvin. Assume that delta H and delta S do not vary with temperature. A. At what temperature will the reaction have delta G zero? So at first, we write down the aspects we already know. We know that delta G should be zero. We know 30 kilojoule and we know 90 joule per Kelvin. But we see that the units are different. We got kilojoule and joule, so we have to bring joule into kilojoule with the factor of thousands. So now we have to take the formula for the free enthalpy, which is delta G is delta H minus the temperature multiplied with the entropy. So now we can put in the things we already know. We know that delta G should be zero. We know 30 kilojoule and we know 0.09 kilojoule per Kelvin. So we search the temperature and therefore we have to bring the temperature and the entropy on the left side. So it looks like this, and now we have to divide through 0.09 kilojoule per Kelvin because we need the temperature on the left side alone. So we got this term, and we see that that we can reduce the units, so we only got Kelvin. And that would be also the end of the task A, because we got a temperature of 333.33 Kelvin or 60.18 degrees. And the temperature is also known as a flow temperature because it's the minimum temperature where the polymerization can start, and it's typical for endotherm and endotroph processes. So that would be the end of task A. Now task B. If the temperature is increased from that in part A, will the reaction be spontaneous or non-spontaneous? So we know the fact that a spontaneous reaction have to be negative and a non-spontaneous reaction positive. So now we see that the sign of our delta S is positive. So if the temperature increased, we would get a negative delta G, because that's important, we got here a minus before the temperature. So therefore we would get a negative delta G. So for example, if we choose a higher temperature than 333 Kelvin, like 400 Kelvin, we would get a result of minus 6, which is negative, and that also shows us that we got a spontaneous reaction. That's also typical for hexagon processes. So that would be the end of task B. I hope that everyone understands my few steps to solve such an exercise, and thank you for your attention.